Please be ready for a dictation of exercise number 22 from January 2021 issue of Progressive Magazine. 5 seconds. Start. Sir, the other day when I initiated the debate, I spoke only for 5 minutes, and during that time I made a reference to Article 39 and Article 41. I also submitted that in spite of 33 years of our independence, states could not implement the directive principles. With reference to that, I also made a mention to the exception of the West Bengal government and the government of Maharashtra. I was discussing the question as to the necessity of the introduction of this particular bill. I said at that time that on many occasions we referred as problems from outside. For example, when there is a price rise, it is usually said that there is price rise in all countries and therefore we cannot help it. It is with reference to the word, I would also like to invite the attention of this august house and the honorable minister as to what is the position abroad. As far as this is concerned, if we have to look to other constitution, a reference of which has been made to the constitution of the world, we find there are about 21 countries in the world wherein this right to work has been recognized, and out of this 21 countries, China, Japan, Russia are there. Not only this, Ireland, from whom we look this inspiration for independence, has also included this right to work as a constitutional right. Not only this, there are other countries also who thought not to include the right to work as a fundamental right in their constitution, have provided for unemployment benefits. We find that there are about 28 countries, which include Switzerland, Sweden, and Australia. It is because of this, I would request the Honorable Minister for Law to consider the constitution of these particular countries who have recognized this particular right, and then consider whether the time has not come after 60 years of independence, and especially when we could not implement the directive principles, whether the time has not come now to consider very seriously this particular problem as to whether this right should be enshrined in our constitution as one of our fundamental rights. As far as our country is concerned, the government of West Bengal unanimously passed a resolution to this effect, and without exception, all agreed to it. I would also like to to invite the attention of the House to Rule 23 of the Declaration of Human Rights, which makes a provision of this right to work, and a directive has been given that all developing countries should provide such a right as a fundamental right in their constitution. This matter was debated. There was an amendment to refer the matter to a select committee. The matter was referred to a select committee, but in the meantime, Parliament was dissolved. I would appeal to the Law Minister to accept the amendment of my friend. The founding father of our Constitution, in the Constituent Assembly, that political democracy cannot survive without economic and social democracy. It is in this background also that we have to take into consideration this particular aspect. The demand for this right to work to be included in the Constitution has been made by many youth organizations. The Janta Yuva Morcha, Yuva Janta Morcha, and the Congress Youth Organization and other youth organizations have all passed resolutions in 1988 and 1989 and requested the government to include this particular right in Constitution. Not only that, I believe that there is no opposition to this bill because my honorable friend, who is not to be seen here now, has introduced a similar bill, number 81 of 1990, where he mentions that where a citizen is not provided with work to enable him to earn his livelihood, the state shall render him assistance with unemployment allowance. When a similar bill was moved in the last parliament, the present minister was very eloquent in his support and said that this should be included in the Constitution immediately. I do not know whether he has changed his mind because of the change of his position from this side to that side. I believe not. There is one more thing to which I would like to invite the attention of the House. Justice Khanna, when he was addressing the 15th annual convocation of Punjab University, said the commitment relating to right to work under Article 39 and 41 have, in the face of mounting unemployment, a strange ring of irony. These articles, he said, pose a question for all those who had been in charge of the affairs of the state as to how far they have carried out the mandate. Stop.